The next topic we are going to see is about stress and strain. So what is meant by stress is when the force is applied, the size or shape or both may change due to change in the relative position of atoms or the molecules. So consider an atom or molecules in this when you are going to apply the force. Okay, what happens? Its size may change or even the position may change. Okay, because of this external force, and this deforming may not be noticeable to our naked eyes, and this deforming, so that change may not be noticeable to our eyes, but it exists in the material itself. So when a body is subjected to such a deforming force, so how much force you apply, so that it changes its position or the shape, and the internal force is developed in it, that is called as a restoring force. Okay, so this deforming force is also called as what here? That is called as a restoring force. And the force per unit area is called as a stress. Okay, force per unit area. So F divided by A, that is called as what? Stress. Okay, so stress is equal to force per unit area. So S is equal to F divided by A. So this is called as stress. Okay, and so it is denoted by the letter sigma. Okay, so stress sigma, which is equal to force divided by area, and so F divided by A. So what is the unit of F? Is it is Newton, and area is meter square. So when you bring this to the numerator, it becomes as n^-2. So this is the unit of stress. Okay, so what is the unit of stress? Is n^-2. The other thing is Pascal. Okay, so n^-2 or Pascal. So its dimensional formula is m^-1 t^-2, and stress is a tensor. Okay, so stress is a tensor. Clear with what is stress? Okay, then next is longitudinal stress. Okay, so we'll just see with the types of stress one by one. First is longitudinal stress. So what is meant by longitudinal stress is if there is any change in the length of the body. Okay, so if there is any change in the length of the body, that comes under the longitudinal stress. So these are all the forces which is being applied. So forces, normal force, and also the tangential force. Okay, and so in this, consider a body. And when many forces act on the system, the center of mass remains at rest. Okay, so this is the object you are considering. And in this object, if there are many forces which are acting, and if you apply with the many forces in all the direction, but the center of mass will be what? It will be always at rest. However, the body gets deformed due to these forces, and so the internal forces appear. So because of all these forces, what happened? The body gets deformed. Deformed is there is some change in the shape of the object. So deformed is there will be some change in the shape of the object. Shape of the object will be changing. Let del A be the cross sectional area. Okay, so area we are considering as del A, then the stress can be written as del is equal to Fn divided by del A, because Fn is a normal force we are considering. Okay, so Fn divided by del A. Okay, and this is for the normal stress which we are writing. Okay, this is a longitudinal stress, and same way when you are writing for the tangential stress, or the other word is shearing stress. Okay, this is for tangential. Normal அப்படின்றதுனால we wrote it as F of N, and here since it is tangential, we are writing as F of T divided by del A. Okay, and again this longitudinal stress is split into two types. They are tensile stress and compressive stress. Okay, so what are the two types of longitudinal stresses? Tensile stress and compressive stress. So first we see with tensile stress. So what is a tensile stress? Is if the internal forces on two sides, okay, if there are two internal forces, then it is stretched by the equal and the opposite forces. Okay, because of this equal and opposite forces, this object has been stressed. Okay, and that is called as a tensile stress. Yes, so internal forces on two sides of del A may pull each other. Okay, so because of the internal force, what happens? They pull each other. That is, it is stretched by equal and opposite forces. Because of equal and opposite forces, they are stretched. Then that longitudinal force is called as a tensile stress. Okay, here also there is, this is a longitudinal. So longitudinal is what? Because of the length that is changing. Okay, but it is in the equal and opposite forces. Okay, so that is called as a tensile stress. Okay, and next is we are going to see is what is a compressive stress. Okay, so what is a compressive stress is because of the same stress. Okay, so that is equal and opposite forces. Okay, and here when on the two sides it has a same equal and opposite forces, but it has been pushed here. Okay, there it has been pulled. Okay, so in tensile and compressive, what is the changes is here it will be pulled outside. Okay, that is called as tensile. Compressive is it has been pushed. Okay, that is compressive. Okay, so when the forces acting on two sides of del A push each other, del A is pushed by equal and opposite forces. Okay, and this is said to be under compression, that is called as a compressive stress. Okay, so this type of longitudinal stress is called as a compressive stress. Clear? Then next is we are going to see is what is a volume stress. So if there is any change in the volume, this happens when the body acted upon by the forces everywhere on the surface, such that the force at any point is normal to the surface and magnitude of the force on the small area is proportional to the area. Okay, that force that is proportional to the surface area. Okay, force is proportional to the pressure into the area. Okay, then when the solid is immersed, the pressure is P and the force for the area del A is given by F is equal to P into del A. Okay, and here F is seem to be perpendicular to the area. Okay, F is perpendicular to the area, and so force per normal unit area, that is what? Del V, that is volume stress. Okay, so the volume stress is the same as what? Pressure. Okay, because what is the before equation we saw is F is equal to P into del A, is it not? This can also be written as F divided by del A is equal to what? P. Okay, instead of del A, we can also write it as A, and so F by A, which is equal to what? P, that is pressure. Okay, so this is the first equation we have got already, and now we are saying that del V is equal to F by A. So comparing with this both, this is also F by A, this is also F by A, so equate this both, so we get del V, which is equal to what? P. Okay, so what is del V is? It is a change in the volume stress. Okay, so that volume stress is equal to what? The pressure. Okay, so volume stress is the same as a pressure. Okay, so this is about the stress. Okay, so we have seen with longitudinal stress and the volume stress. In longitudinal stress, we have the two types of stress. They are tensile and compressive stress. Clear?